My name's Robbie Strachan. I'm a gapper, mission Africa gapper. I'm going to stay with Jeremy and Rachel Nash down in Legmoin. We're here in the Sim guest house in Ouagadougou. We arrived really very early this morning. It's now about 11 o'clock and we're just about to head down towards Gawa, the 7-hour drive towards Legmoin in Gawa, which should be fun.
And what are your first impressions?
Well, it's dusty and red. It's quite exciting, really. I haven't seen much of the city in the light, which is a bit unfortunate. We're just about to see, so that'll be good.
Good. So, to be continued.
To be continued.
Okay, Emma, how are you today?
I'm fine, thanks.
Good. Can you tell us where are we?
We are in Legmoin at the moment, on our way to my new house.
Okay. Now, over here just behind us, there's a number of houses here. Young fellow in the field, cow and so forth. But this house here, tell us about it.
It was the first house we considered as maybe a place for me to live.
Mm-hmm.
We actually decided it needed quite a bit doing. For example, the shower needs a bit off, mm-hmm. needs a bit more height.
Right.
Inside it needed a lot doing, so we decided that it might not be the best first option. Now we're going to the house that we have actually rented.
Okay.
Where we've done some work in already.
Okay, lead on. So what would you say are the good features about this house?
It's big. Well, okay. To me it's big. The living room has got a lot of light because you've got the two doors opposite each other.
Mm-hmm.
And you've actually separate rooms that they've separated.
Mm-hmm.
Rather than, you know, just one big area. It's built with good stones, not the mm-hmm. local material they use.
Mm-hmm.
And I like the roof. It's a proper roof.
Tin, very good. keeps the rain out.
Yes.
Yeah. Excellent.
I'm in the bathroom now. I'm very pleased it's a bathroom inside. However, the toilet is outside.
So Anna, we're back in your house again. What's new here today?
Well, the next set of bookshelves has arrived.
Very good.
I'm afraid I need to balance it a little bit.
Okay, bit wobbly, but sorry.
In one of the other rooms there's a wardrobe and something that's going to serve as a kitchen sink.
Good. So we're making progress.
Yes, definitely.
Excellent. And then later on this week, You'll go up to Ouagadougou, maybe get a fridge.
A fridge, a cooker, a motorbike, but that's not for the house.
No. Very good.
Yes, I arrived in September, so I've been here about 4 months. I've been doing what they call an orientation period, which means you visit everybody who is, all the missionaries who are within the team. That's been very interesting, to see what people are doing, to see the different areas. It's also been a little bit relaxing because you still don't have any responsibilities.
Mm-hmm.
On the other hand, obviously it was with a view of deciding where is your ministry going to be. So you kind of do weigh up what you see, what you hear. Kind of seeing, is this where God's leading me?
Okay, so you've seen around now, so I understand you're going to be engaged in two different things, yes?
Yes, yeah, I'll be involved with the coordination of the translation office, which is the translation of the Old Testament into Birifor. They do have already the New Testament in Birifor. There is some problem, in a sense, with the coordination administration side of things.
Okay.
The people who are there are good translators, but not very good in office work. The other side I'm going to be involved in is actually with Jeremy and Rachel Nash, who have been here for about 12 years, to provide or to create, what is it? To get some new material out for people who have just learned to read and write.
Okay.
There are
good. Lots
of alphabetizations campaigns going on, but there is actually not follow-up material. And what I would like to do is to provide them with good Christian material for the Christians that they then can use as a follow-up for reading themselves and learning, but also for evangelization, because the campaigns are actually given to everybody, not Christians and non-Christians alike, but there is no material in Dagari available at all.
Okay, and just for one last question, what one thing would you like people to pray for?
For a good relationship with the church here and the Christians here.
Amen to that. Thank you very much. Sort of hard to see in the dark here, but this is Robbie. Yes, we can make out his face here now. What have you been doing, Robbie?
Getting awfully messy. All my hands, though. Basically, we're whitewashing Anna's house, making it lovely and light, because it's not too light in here. There's only small windows. And the white paint.
A job well done by the look of it. We can only see it very dimly on the video, but
it's beautiful.
It looks beautiful. It looks beautiful. else do you do besides building churches and foyers and so forth?
Well, at this time of year, which is the dry season, I'm very much involved with both correspondence courses. So I'm helping organise people to take correspondence courses into primary schools, into secondary schools, to Christian youth groups, so that people can study the Word of God. And the other thing I'm doing is taking the Jesus film out. When churches invite me, I go and we show the film in several villages, and I take the opportunity to teach the Christians about evangelism, giving their testimonies, and encouraging them with carrying on the vision of evangelism after I've gone.
And what would you say is the biggest challenge in that branch of your work?
The biggest challenge is getting people on board, to take it to heart that it's their responsibility to reach out. They can't always look to the mission or missionaries to do the work. They need to be involved themselves.
And would you have one or two prayer points you'd want to share with the people back in the UK, just for their prayers?
Please pray for the correspondence courses. We're doing a lot of distribution and people marking courses, but we really need praying that the word that they're studying would really touch their lives, that people would come to Sunday schools, be encouraged in their faith through that. And the other thing is that people would take to heart the evangelism, that the church would really have an evangelistic zeal.
Okay. And any prayer points for the Nash family?
Prayer points for the Nash family? Oh.
Where do we start there?
Pray for the children's schooling. Rachel has a real challenge with the children's schooling. Pray for wisdom in all the people that come and the needs that we have to discern where to help, how to help. So, grace and wisdom.
Thank you, brother, and the Lord bless you.
Thank you.
Well, greetings from Legmoin Village. Thank you for all your prayers for us, especially for schooling. It was never very easy with the three different classes. Toby has a class now too, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, do you like school?
Yeah.
Do you like school?
No.
Ah! You do like school?
No.
Okay, do you like school?
Not internet school, but I like homeschool.
But we battle on each day. So everyone's just about to disappear off to Wagadougou, apart from us and Robbie. So we're going to be holding the home front here, keeping on our normal school routine and playing and looking after chickens and dogs and cats. That's about it, really. So thank you very much for your part in our ministry. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much. The Lord bless you.
Well, tell me, would you like to greet the people back in Ireland and the UK from Mission Africa?
Okay.
And do you have any prayer requests you would like to communicate to them?
Yeah. In fact, I'm very glad to receive Paul here. And it was a very pleasant time to meet him. And I just want to send my greeting to all the people in Ireland and to and England too. And I want to here say I appreciate very much the relationship, the partnership between us. Okay. And I do like that God may help us to continue in that partnership so that we can build up the kingdom of God in what we are doing. Now, the philosophy of the church is to use social action in order to reach unreached people.
Mm.
This is what really this is the philosophy that we have adopted now.
Yeah.
And we do really want you to pray for us so that we can implement that vision that we have. And we think that is the will of God, that we can reach people toward our action.
Okay.
I think the gospel is not made up only of preaching.
Yeah.
But it's made up of action.
Of action, exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, be assured we're with you in action and in prayer,
yeah.
And we wish you every blessing on your God.
Okay.
Thank you so much.